Another really, really wicked new feature that is being added into Flash CS5.5 is the ability to, as they're calling it, to incremental compile, which basically means is that some things while you compile will be stored into your RAM or even onto your hard drive. Now, a few things to note that before we get deeper into this. One is that it depends on your authoring time. That means as soon as you close your editor, all that got deleted. So it's really while you're working, and that's really when you need it, when you're recompiling and recompiling a file over and over. To showcase this example, we've created a small little sample that has an MP3 file that is being recompiled. Currently, there are two things that you need to know about it. Now, obviously, I believe that in the future, this is going to get much more sophisticated and much more features, I hope at least, because this is so, so cool. So currently, like we were saying, as soon as you close your Flash, everything is cleared. Whenever you click on the clear cache, which is in your control, clear publish cache, it's going to clear the cache on all the files in your application. It's not file specific, okay? Now, the next thing is that the sound file, only if it's being recompiled for Flash, that means if there's an MP3 file that is changing and Flash is recompressing it, it will not recompress it over and over, alright? So the two things that it will support is MP3 files while it's compiling to MP3 files, and fonts. In the future, there'll probably be more features and more capabilities, but currently, that's all you really need to know to start working with it. If I run my application, let me first make sure that I clear my publish cache. If I run my application now, you'll see that it's going to take it 1, 2, maybe 3 seconds until it starts loading, and then my music will start playing. Now, if I run it one more time now, you'll see how quickly it will run. There is no wait at all. So basically the reason is because our MP3 file was really taking the majority of the time of the compiling, and now with this new feature, we don't have to wait for it to recompile each time. Now if you explicitly wanted it to recompile, you could go to your control and clear publish cache and test movie and do it right ahead, but I don't really see where there would be a lot of reasons for that, as if you change your file or you change anything in the settings, Flash is smart enough to notice that and it would recompile it automatically. Now, if you need to change the settings of how much memory is being stored, or more accurately, how much hard drive are you willing to dedicate for this, you could find that option inside of your Flash preferences. And in your Flash preferences, you'll see that there's a new tab called Publish Cache. And in your Publish Cache, you could play around with these properties. I haven't played around with them too much, but I believe that the default should work for most scenarios, but obviously if you need more space, obviously add more space for the cache itself or for the disk cache itself.